In the energy quadrant today, taking a look at the March WTI crude oil futures, which fall in price, largest one-day drop in price since November 30th of 2021. Crude has now fallen 4.25% from yesterday's high of 95.82. It's very early in the week, obviously, but if we finished here, currently down about 1.15% or so, it would be the first down week in the last nine and only the third in the last 12. Now the high today, 95.16, was actually 30 cents lower than yesterday's close of 95.46. So pretty much a down day all day. 90.66 was the low. That was down 5.02%. And we settled above $98, almost to $92, about 91.78 or so, down about 3.8%. Give or take a few tenths of a percent there. Now, the Russia-Ukraine situation was part of it. Vladimir Putin announced that a date for the pullback of some troops at the Ukraine border has been decided upon, but NATO is waiting for the visual evidence. This all obviously took the shock trade, the potential weapon of Vladimir Putin pulling back as the third largest oil producer for the world, taking some of that oil off the market as a weapon. That's pulled back that risk a little bit if diplomacy is actually working to slow down or kind of ease tensions between these two nations and the NATO countries that support the Ukraine. So that took a little bit of the rally out of the crude oil markets, and also Iranian supply, according to EU diplomat Joseph Borrell, may be coming to market sometime in the near future. He said an Iranian deal, and I quote, is in sight, close quotes, and he urged compromise between Western countries and Iran to get there. And if we got a new nuclear deal, Iran would be able to sell some of the oil they can't get rid of on the open market. So that also a headwind for crude oil today. But we did pop up off the lows by over 1%. So we'll have to see if this is a change in trend or just a one-day relief trade.